Hello friends, welcome to our channel. So in this session, let us have a discussion on two more transformation functions in computer graphics. So far we have learned the basic transformation functions: scaling, rotation and translation. So for those three transformations, we have already derived the formulas. So for finding the new coordinates, that means after completing this transformation. And then we have learned what is the importance of homogeneous coordinates and how the two-dimensional coordinate can be represented in a two-dimensional, in homogeneous coordinates, and what are the formula, that means a homogeneous matrix representation for all these three basic transformation functions. And now let us see the two more transformation functions, that is reflection and sharing. As we have seen in the previous session, the translation means moving the object from one position to another object, and rotation means rotating an object within a certain angle. And in the case of scaling, in order to change the size and shape of an object, that depends upon the scaling parameters. And here in the sharing, one coordinate will be fixed and there will be some distortion on another coordinate. That means we will have both X share and Y share. So this is also called as skewing technique. Right? So in the X share, Y dash will be same, that means at the old coordinate, and X dash will be having some distortion. That means X plus SHX into Y. So here we will have two parameters. Similarly, sharing of with respect to X and sharing with respect to Y. So if X share, in the X share, we need a factor called sharing parameter with respect to X axis. So in the X share, Y coordinate will be fixed, that means a constant. And X, there will be a distortion in X coordinate, so that the image will be in a slanting position. So you will be better understandable if we see the example. Now let us write the formula, then we will move on to the example. So Y dash is equal to Y and X dash is equal to X plus sharing parameter into Y in the X share. So coming to the Y share, the X dash will be the same, that means there will be no change in X coordinate. And the Y coordinate will be changed, that is Y plus, here we will use another sharing parameter, that is with respect to Y axis, SHY into X. So in the X share, Y dash is equal to Y, that means Y will be not changed, X dash will be having some distortion based upon the given sharing parameter SHX, here SHY. Now let us see an example so that you can better understand regarding this X share and Y share, how the object can be changed. Let us consider a triangle, a square, see, so let us consider a square with coordinates 0, 0, 0, 2, 2, 0, 2, 2. It's a square. Now let us apply the sharing, X share, where SHX is equal to 2 units. So that the new coordinates, let us consider each coordinate and we can find the new coordinates. Coming to this 0, 0. For this one, so in the X share, Y will be the same. So Y dash is equal to 0, X dash is equal to X plus sharing, sharing of x 2 into 0, that is equal to 0, x dash. So x dash comma y dash is equal to 0 comma 0. Hope you understand. So in the x share, the y coordinate will be same, there will be distortion in the x coordinate. So here let us consider the we are calculating the x share with 2 units. So that consider first point 0 comma 0, the new coordinate, we have to find out the new coordinate x dash and y dash. So x and y are 0 0, so y dash is equal to 0 because y dash is equal to y, and x dash is equal to x plus, so that means 0 plus, sharing parameter 2 into 0, that is 0. Consider the second point 0 comma 2. So again y dash is equal to 2, x dash is equal to x plus 2 into 2, that is equal to 4, x dash is equal to 4, therefore x dash comma y dash is equal to 4 comma 2. Similarly, consider the, so this is the, see, y dash is equal to the same coordinate 2, x dash is equal to x plus 2 into y, that is 2, 4. Now let us consider the third point 2 comma 0. So y dash is equal to 0, x dash is equal to x plus 2 into 0, x dash is equal to 2, therefore x dash comma y dash is equal to 2 comma 0, right? Now let us consider the next coordinate 2 comma 2. So from this 2 comma 2, let us consider y dash is equal to same, that is 2, x dash is equal to x plus 2 plus 2 into y, that is 2, that is equal to 2, 2 plus 4 is equal to 6, therefore x dash comma y dash is equal to 2, sorry, 6 comma 2. So consider the first point 0 comma 0 and find out the new coordinates with applying the same formula. So 0 comma 0, 0, 0 comma 0, the new coordinates will be again the 0 comma 0. And consider the second point 0 comma 2, apply the formula so that for the next coordinate, the new coordinates will be 4 comma 2. And consider the third point 2 comma 0 and find out the formula. So calculate the formula so that we can get the new coordinate as 2 comma 0, the same, it remains same. And consider the fourth coordinate, that is 2 comma 2, and apply the formula and we will get the new coordinate 6 comma 2. Now let us draw the square after applying the x share. The now points are 0 comma 0, so this is one point. Next 4 comma 2, so 4 comma 2, this is another point. And next 2 comma 0, 2 comma 0. Next 6 comma 2, 6 2. So that square becomes a parallelogram after applying the x share. So in a slanting position, the object moves in a slanting position. So it's an x-axis, so y doesn't change, but x will change its positions. So this is a formula for x share. So y dash is equal to y, x dash is equal to x plus the sharing parameters, how many units that it must share. So that sx into y coordinate. So we are considering the same square, applying the formula and finding the new coordinates. Now let us consider the y share. So after y share, how the object is changed. So this is an example for x share. Hope you understood this x share. Now let us move on to the y share. Same, let us consider the same parameter, same units. SHY is equal to 2 units. So the same formula. So x dash will be the same, but y dash will be having some distortions. So x dash will be same, that is 0. Y dash is equal to y plus 2 into x, that is 0. So new coordinates x dash comma y dash is equal to 0 comma 0. This is the first point. Coming to the second point, 0 comma 2. X dash will be the same 0, y dash is equal to y plus 2 plus 2 into 0, that is equal to 2. Therefore x dash comma y dash is equal to 0 comma 2, the new coordinate. And coming to the third coordinate, 2 comma 0. So x dash will be same, y dash is equal to y plus 2 into 2, that is equal to 4. So x dash comma y dash is equal to 0 comma, sorry, 2 comma 4. Consider the last point, 2 comma 2. X dash will be the same. Y dash is equal to 2 plus 2 into 2, that is equal to 6. Therefore x dash comma y dash is equal to 2 comma 6. So same procedure we have applied, but the formula is somewhat different. In the y share, the x coordinate will be the same, but this, there will be some distortion in x y coordinate. So y dash is equal to y plus shy into x. So apply the same formula for all the coordinates and find the new coordinates of a square. Now let us draw the graph. See, that is rather, so this is the x share. This is the x share. Now, in the y share, the first coordinate is 0, 0. The next one is 0, comma 2. That is this one. Next one is 2, comma 4. 2 to 4. Next, 2, comma 6. 2, comma 6. See, now the graph is, the object moves in this direction. So this is 2, comma 4, 2, comma 6. This is 4, comma 2. 6 comma 2. This is y share. So in the x share, the object square, normal square, changes into the parallelogram. And here also, in the y share also, it becomes a parallelogram. So that means some slanting position, the object will slants, right? So hope you understood the both the x share and y share. This is a one more transformation function. And what is the matrix representation for this sharing application? One, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is the sharing for share matrix, homogeneous matrix representation for x share. Then y share, for y share similarly 1, 0, 0, shy 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is a formula for y share. So simply we can calculate, we can multiply each coordinate. So first convert this 0, 0 into homogeneous, that becomes 0, 0, 1. And this becomes 0, 2, 1. This becomes 2, 2, 0, 1, and this becomes 2, 2, 1. So directly we can apply the product for this matrix so that we can get the new coordinates. So this is a homogeneous matrix representation for sharing transformation. So 1 SHX 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. So here X Y 1, here also X Y 1, X dash Y dash 1, H X dash Y dash H is equal. Right, hope you understood this sharing, and let us move on to the next one, that is reflection. So here we will be having two different cases, the mini cases in the reflection. Reflection means getting a mirror image for an object. That means rotating an object in 180 degrees. So 180 degrees rotation of an object gives the reflection. So the first one is reflection with respect to x-axis, with respect to x-axis, right? So let us write here x-axis. That means so if there is an object here, if there is an object here, so with respect to x-axis, that means after reflection the object will be this. So this is an original object, this is a reflected object. So reflected object, for this we can have a formula. So x dash y dash H is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0, -1, 0, 0, 0, 1 into X, Y, 1. So this is a formula, homogeneous matrix representation for the reflection along x-axis. So this transformation function can be understood only if you solve a problem. Example, if you see the example. So let us have an example. Let us consider a triangle with the points 2, 2. So triangle with 2, 2, 3, 2, and 4, 2. Sorry, 3, 4. 3, 4. 2, 2, 3, 2. Let us plot here 2, 2. That means this is the point 2, 2. 3, 2. Here 3, 2. can get the perfect. So for this we need to do x dash y dash h is equal to 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1 into 2 2 1. So for this the homogeneous coordinate is 2 comma 2 comma 1, because h is equal to 1, so the same 1 should be multiplied for both x and y coordinates. So the x and y coordinates will not change. 2 comma 2 comma 1 will be the homogeneous coordinate for the two dimensional coordinate 2 comma 2. So just multiply it. So 1 2 is 2 plus 0 plus 0, 0, 0 into 2 0, minus 1 into 2 minus 2 0 0 0 1. So these are the points. If we multiply this, we will get the point. So again convert into two dimensional, so that is 2 comma minus 2 first quadrant. For the first point, the point is, the new point is 2 comma minus 2. Coming to the next one, 4 comma 2, so apply the same 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1 into 4 2 1. So homogeneous coordinate is 4 comma 2 comma 1. Multiply this 4, 0 into 2 0, 0 into 1 0, 0 into 4 0, minus 1 into 2 minus 2, 0 into 1 0, 0 into 4 0, 0 into 2 0, 1 into 1 1. So these are the points. So again convert it into 2 dimensional, that is 4 comma minus 2 is the new coordinate for 4 comma 2. And coming to the third one, that is 3 comma 4. Consider the 3 comma 4, convert it to homogeneous, 3 comma 4 comma 1, and apply the formula 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1 into 3 4 1. So that we will get 1 into 3 3 0 0, 0 into 3 0, minus 1 into 4 minus 4, 0 into 1 0, 0 into 3 0 is 1. So the two dimensional coordinate is 3 comma minus 4. So the new points are 2 comma minus 2, 4 comma minus 2, 3 comma minus 4. Let us plot here. So 2 comma minus 2, that means 2 comma minus 2, that means here it is 4 comma minus 2, here it is 3 comma minus 4, here it is. So this is 3 comma minus 4, 4 comma minus 2, 2 comma minus 2. So this is just a mirror image. It is called a reflection. That means 180 degrees, rotating this object into 180 degrees. So this is with respect to x-axis. So if we consider, that means if we use the reflection with respect to y-axis, the formula will change and the procedure is same. So again we can derive the matrix format, homogeneous coordinate, homogeneous matrix representation, and just multiply the old coordinates with this homogeneous matrix representation so that you can get the new coordinates. So I will write the formula for all the cases so that you can solve the same example for all the given cases. Right, hope you understood this well. X-axis, so reflection towards the x-axis means The formula is 1 0 0 0 minus 1 0 0 0 1 into x y 1. So this is a homogeneous matrix representation for reflection around x axis. So we are considering an example. We are considering a triangle with the coordinates 2, 2, 4, 2, and 3, 4. So here, considering each and every coordinate, so just converting this two-dimensional coordinate into homogeneous coordinate, and then we are just multiplying it with the homogeneous matrix. So we get the two-dimensional new coordinate. So similarly, we have to apply the same procedure for all the points so that we can get the new points. Again, just plot the graph for the new coordinates so that you can observe the clear mirror image of a object. Now I will write the formula for all the different cases of a reflection so that you can solve the example for all the cases. The same example you can take and you can solve just doing a multiplication, right? So you can observe the reflection perfectly. I will write down the different cases of a reflection. So we have seen the reflection towards x-axis, now reflection towards y-axis. Reflection towards y-axis means if the triangle is taken here, the mirror image is here, it will become here. So this is a reflected object. This is the reflected object. So let us consider the homogeneous representation matrix x dash y dash h is equal to -1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 into x y 1. So here y is nothing but homogeneous coordinate. We are considering it as a one. So the same formula. This is a formula for reflection around y-axis. Now let us have a look for origin, reflection towards the origin. Third case, origin, reflection with origin. So if you consider the triangle here, with respect to origin, the reflection will be like this. So this is the reflected object. This is a reflected object, and the formula is x dash y dash h is equal to -1 0 0 0 -1 0 0 0 1 into x y 1. So this is the formula for reflection towards the origin. Next case, reflection towards y is equal to x. Fourth case, reflection towards y is equal to x. A line y is equal to x. So let it be, this is a line y is equal to x. If there is a triangle like this, the mirror object will be like this. This is the reflection. This is the reflected object. Now the homogeneous matrix representation is x dash y dash h is equal to 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 1 into x y 1. Homogeneous h is equal to 1. So this is the reflection from a line y is equal to x. So these are the different cases in the reflection, and these are the different homogeneous representations, matrix representations for this reflection. So that I hope you understood the first example, that is reflection along x-axis. The same procedure we have to apply for all these cases. So consider the same triangle, that means same example which we have taken in the first case, and you can solve it for all the remaining cases, and you can easily observe the perfect reflection of an object. So let us stop here in this session, and in the next session I will explain regarding these composite transformations. Hope you understood today's session. Thank you.